Charles' laughter ceased as he tiptoed by that dreaded open door. With a cursory glance into its depths, as if to reassure, he never really understood what first made him hit that room. But childish intuition knew something lurked within its gloom. In it a room held many things that came from long ago, but why they were kept within that room, a child of eight would know. He sensed a dark force that dwelt within, that watched his every move. Hidden deep within the shadowy bowels of that accursed room, it took every bit of courage to retrieve that bouncing ball that always rode into that room when he was playing in the hall. Sheer terror would grip the child's heart if he found himself alone, and the glimpse of a fleeting figure who had turned his legs to stone. have passed and the memories dim. The child is now full grown, still living in the family house with young children of his own. His sights are now firmly set upon the furthering of his life, aided and abetted by a materialistic wife. But his eldest son has a morbid fear of the antiques room off the hall, and he keeps leaving a trail of salt along the room's perimeter.